everyone, my name is Kendrick, and welcome to Travel and Live Free. In this video, we're gonna cover the new Aeroplan program that was just recently launched, coming right up. On November 9, 2020, the new Aeroplan program was launched. The new program has a lot of changes from the previous program, and what we're gonna do in this video is we're gonna cover all the different changes that happened during the launch date, as well as how you can earn Aeroplan points moving forward. We'll also cover how you can redeem those Aeroplan points, and we'll talk about all the different rules as well as different strategies on the best way for you to redeem those points. So first, what is new with the new Aeroplan program versus the old program? First off, the old Aeroplan website is no longer in use. Instead, you will be using the Air Canada website. Aeroplan miles has also been renamed to Aeroplan points, and fuel surcharge has been eliminated. Flight rewards is now a hybrid between geographical zones and distance base, and there's also gonna be 4 zones that you can redeem your points in. And those 4 zones are North America, Atlantic, Pacific, and South America. There is now a total of 10 different travel zone combinations when you make a redemption, and that also excludes the class of service if you choose to fly on economy, premium economy, business class, or first class. You now have 18 months instead of 12 months to keep your account active, and they also have a new micro redemption feature that allows you to use your points for seat selection, onboard Wi-Fi, onboard meals, and drinks. Altitude qualifying mile is now called status qualifying miles. Altitude qualifying segments is now called status qualifying segments. Altitude qualifying dollars is now called status qualifying dollars. And there's also a new family sharing feature. Now we're gonna jump in and talk about how you can earn Aeroplan points in the new program. So the methods that you used to earn Aeroplan miles back in the old program is still valid. You can still get the American Express Business Platinum card. You can still get the American Express Platinum card, as well as the American Express Gold card and the American Express Business Gold card. You can take those American Express points and transfer them to the new Aeroplan program. Now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna cover all the new rebranded credit cards that have been released by American Express, TD, and CIBC. Before we jump in and talk about all the different credit cards that the new Aeroplan program has released, let's go over a lot of the new credit card benefits first, because as I go over the different credit cards, you'll notice that depending if the credit card is an entry-level credit card, a core credit card, or a premium credit card, they have different features that they would provide to individuals who sign up for them. So the first one is that people who get the core or premium credit cards will get their first check bag for free. There's also a shared benefit with secondary cardholder for core and premium cardholders. And premium card holders will also get Maple Leaf lounge access. There's also priority airport services for premium card holders, such as priority boarding, check-in, and standby. Premium card holders can also get an annual worldwide companion pass after spending $25,000. And the companion pass base fare is as follows. It's gonna be $99 for travel within Canada and the US, excluding Hawaii. $299 for flights to Hawaii, Mexico, Central America, or the Caribbean. $499 for flights to South America, Europe, Middle East, and Africa. And $599 for flights to Asia, Australia, and New Zealand. TD and CIBC will also have a $100 Nexus rebate. There's also no expiry on Aeroplan points on all credit card tiers. And you can also get an elite status qualification boost of 1,000 status qualifying mile and 15 qualifying segment for core and premium tier credit card holders. There's also rollover status qualifying miles and rollover e-upgrade credits for people who has the premium tier credit cards. And finally, a lot of these cards will offer a body pass, which is essentially a buy one, get one free pass. And the only thing that you have to pay is taxes. So the first credit card we're gonna go over is the American Express Aeroplan card. And this card gives you 9,000 Aeroplan points earned after spending $15,000 within the first 3 months, and 1,000 Aeroplan points earned after spending $500 per month for the next 6 months. This is a core Aeroplan credit card, so you get the core Aeroplan credit card benefits, and there's a $120 annual fee. Next, there's the American Express Aeroplan Reserve card. This card gives you 35,000 Aeroplan points and $100 statement credit after spending $3,000 within the first 3 months, and 5,000 Aeroplan points earned after spending $1,000 per month for the first 6 months. This is also a premium Aeroplan credit card, and the annual fee is $499. Next, we have the American Express Aeroplan Business Reserve Card. This card gives you 35,000 Aeroplan points, as well as $100 statement credit after spending $5,000 within the first 3 months of getting this card. You can also get 5,000 Aeroplan points after spending $1,000 per month for the first 6 months of having this card. This card is a premium Aeroplan credit card, and the annual fee is $499. Next, we have the TD Aeroplan Visa Platinum Card. This card gives you 10,000 Aeroplan points after your first purchase. This is an entry-level Aeroplan credit card, and it has an annual fee of $89, but it's rebated for the first year. Next, we have the TD Aeroplan Infinite Visa. This one gives you 10,000 Aeroplan points after your first purchase, and it's a core level Aeroplan credit card, and there's a $139 annual fee, which is rebated for the first year. Next, we have the TD Aeroplan Infinite Visa Privilege Card, and this card gives you 20,000 Aeroplan points after your first purchase, 30,000 Aeroplan points, and a buddy pass after spending $3,000 in your first 3 months of having this credit card, and this is a premium level Aeroplan credit card. This card also comes with a $599 annual fee. Next, we have the TD Aeroplan Business Visa Card. This card gives you 10,000 Aeroplan points after your first purchase, gives you a buddy pass after spending $1,000 within the first 3 months of getting this card, and a $149 annual fee, which is rebated for the first year. Next, we have the CIBC Aeroplan Visa Platinum Card. This card gives you 10,000 Aeroplan points after your first purchase. It's an entry-level Aeroplan credit card, and it has no annual fee for the first year. Next, we have the CIBC Aeroplan Infinite Visa Card. It has a $139 annual fee, which is rebated for the first year, but that annual fee is rebated continuously if you have a CIBC Smart Plus account. You could also get a buddy pass after spending $3,000 within the first 4 months of getting this card, and you get 10,000 Aeroplan points after your first purchase. This is actually the credit card that I personally have, but I got this card before the rebranding, so they pretty much just changed my card to this card, but I got it previously before the changes and the launch of the new Aeroplan program. And this card is also a core level Aeroplan credit card. Next, we have the CIBC Aeroplan Infinite Privilege Visa Card. This card has a $599 annual fee, and the annual fee is rebated by $139 if you have the CIBC Smart Plus account. You get 20,000 Aeroplan points after your first purchase, and you can also get a buddy pass after spending $3,000 within the first 4 months of getting this card. This card is a premium level Aeroplan credit card. Next, we have the CIBC Aeroplan Business Visa Card. This card gives you 10,000 Aeroplan points after your first purchase. You get a buddy pass after spending $3,000 within the first 4 months of getting this card. There's also an annual fee of $180, which is rebated for the first year. The personal income requirement for this card is $35,000. Next, we have the CIBC Aeroplan Business Visa Plus. This card gives you 10,000 Aeroplan points after your first purchase, and there is a buddy pass that you can earn after spending $3,000 within the first 4 months of getting this card. There's an annual fee of $120, which is rebated for the first year. So unlike the other CIBC Business Visa Card, this one does not have an income requirement, but they do have to check your business to see if they want to approve you for this card or not. Next, we have the CIBC Aeroplan Visa Student Card. This card gives you 10,000 Aeroplan points after your first purchase, and it's an entry-level Aeroplan credit card, and there's no annual fee for the first year. So this is essentially the same credit card as the CIBC Aeroplan Visa that we talked about earlier, except this one was made for students. Other ways that you can earn Aeroplan points besides the credit card sign-up bonuses includes going through Asking Canadians, which is a survey website that can give you a few points for every survey that you complete. You can also go through the Rocket Miles website, where you can book an accommodation, and in return, they will give you Aeroplan points. However, the hotels do usually have a bigger markup compared to booking on the hotel website directly, so do keep that in mind. I think Rocket Miles is only good if you need to top up your points. In that case, then you can stay in a hotel, pay a little bit more money, but top up your Aeroplan points balance for use for your next redemption. You can also convert your Merit Bonvoy points to Aeroplan points at a 3-to-1 ratio. In my opinion, transferring your Merit Bonvoy points to Aeroplan is not a good use of your points. However, for some people, if your balance is very close to that next Aeroplan redemption, then it might not be a bad idea to just top it up with some Merit points. For every 60,000 Merit points that you transfer over to Aeroplan, they're gonna give you an additional 5,000 Aeroplan points. So if you do have to transfer to Aeroplan for Merit Bonvoy, then that's the path that I would take personally. Next, we're gonna cover all the rules when it comes to redeeming those Aeroplan points. All Aeroplan points booking are basically one-way flights. And under Aeroplan, they call it one-way bound. You're allowed to have 6 segments for every one-way bound, and there is a maximum of 12 segments for Air Canada flights. So if you have an Air Canada in your itinerary, then you can only have a maximum of 12 segments. If you use 100% partner carriers, then you can have up to 16 different segments. You can combine a maximum of 6 different one-way bounds in one ticket to create an itinerary. There is a $39 partner booking fee if you decide to have a partner, and there is also a $30 phone booking fee if you decide to make this booking over the phone, which you have to because at the moment the Aeroplan website is not yet complete in terms of putting together your own custom itinerary, just like the old Aeroplan mini around the world method. When paying a change fee, you're gonna pay the change fee per one-way bound, but the cancellation fee is for the entire ticket. For every one-way bound that you redeem, you're also eligible for a stopover as long as you're willing to pay 5,000 Aeroplan points to stake a stopover somewhere along the lines when you are flying towards your destination. You are not allowed to backtrack to the same airport on a one-way bound. However, if you're putting together several one-way bounds, then on the second or third one-way bounds, then you can backtrack to the same airport as long as it's on separate one-way bounds. You can also use the priority reward voucher on the combined 6 one-way bound flights. The new award search will return up to 150 results per search, plus new criteria for sorting and filtering. So you can find that new sorting and filtering on the top left corner of the Aeroplan website. You can also mix and match class of service when putting together your itinerary. So for example, in one of your one-way bound, it's all on business class. On the next one-way bounds, then it's on economy. So basically, I think the logical thing to do is that if it's a short flight, then economy is more than enough. But if you are flying on a long-haul flight, then business class makes more sense. You can now search using IATA codes. For example, instead of JFK or EWR, you can put NYC instead. The Air Canada flights also have a dynamic pricing now. However, partner flights still have a fixed price. Flying more than 100% the direct distance between two points breaks the circuitous routing. However, at the moment, this doesn't seem to be enforced heavily. So you can actually go a little bit over, and at the moment, it's okay. However, in the future, this might be more enforced. So at the time of this video being filmed, at the moment, this is not enforced heavily. There's three methods of redemption. You can redeem by all points. You can also redeem points plus cash with a minimum of 60% of points requirement plus the remainder in cash. And of course, the standard taxes and cash that you are familiar with the old program. There's also some weird hidden rules that is currently in place right now. And at the moment, this is how it works, but perhaps in the future, this is not how it's gonna work. For example, if you wanna fly from Pacific to Atlantic, you are allowed to transit through North America and even have a stopover there as long as your stopover is not in Canada or the US. If you're flying from North America to the Atlantic zone, then you are not allowed to transit in the Pacific zone. That means you can't put a stopover in the Pacific zone on your way to the Atlantic zone when flying starting from North America. If you're flying from North America to the Pacific zone, you are allowed to transit in the Atlantic zone. Intra-Pacific flights may sometimes transit through Atlantic, sometimes you cannot. North America to South America flights have to be between those two zones, and they cannot transit through Atlantic or the Pacific zone. Air Canada flights will only calculate the amount of points you need to redeem based on the direct distance between your starting point and your destination. Your connections are not counted as long as you don't fly more than 100% of the distance between your starting point and destination. If you redeem your flights with partner airlines, you do need to add the flights segment by segment to determine how much points you need to redeem. Another thing that I notice is that there seems to be a reduction of points that you need to redeem if you're flying on Air Canada flights, if you have Air Canada 25K status, and or if you have a core credit card such as the CIBC Aeroplan Infinite Visa or the TD Aeroplan Infinite Visa. Using an example that I found while searching, I noticed that a flight between Vancouver to Calgary only costs 5,100 points. Normally, a flight between Vancouver and Calgary would cost you 6,000 points. So this is a savings of 900 points. I also did a search for international flights between Vancouver and Tokyo, and I noticed that on economy, instead of charging you the usual 35,000 points because of the Air Canada 25K status or having a core credit card, then the amount of points that you're gonna need is only 30,400. I also noticed the same thing with business class, where instead of paying 55,000 points for the flight to Tokyo from Vancouver, you're only gonna be paying 50,200 for a savings of 4,800 points. So that means if you are redeeming your points on an Air Canada flight, it really helps to have either Aeroplan 25K status or having a core credit card. As a matter of fact, if you have a core credit card and an Air Canada 25K status or higher, then you can even increase the amount of discount you get on points. However, the discount is very minimal versus if you just had one or the other. So the biggest jump in terms of discount is if you get the 25K status or if you get a core credit card. Next, we're gonna cover the new Aeroplan Elite status. The status tiers is as follows. There's a 25K, 35K, 50K, 75K, and Super Elite status. In order to qualify for 25K status, you either need to have 25,000 status qualifying miles or 25 status qualifying segments plus $3,000 of status qualifying dollars. In order to get Aeroplan 35K, you need 35,000 status qualifying miles or 35 status qualifying segments plus $4,000 spent on status qualifying dollars. In order to get Aeroplan 50K, you need to have 50,000 status qualifying miles or 50 status qualifying segments plus $6,000 spent on status qualifying dollars. If you wanna get Aeroplan 75K, you need to have 75,000 status qualifying miles or 75 status qualifying segments plus $9,000 spent on status qualifying dollars. If you wanna get Super Elite, you need 100,000 status qualifying miles or 100 status qualifying segments plus $20,000 spent on status qualifying dollars. You can also get Aeroplan 25K if you earn 100,000 Aeroplan points per year with one of your credit cards. However, this excludes sign-up bonuses and transferring points. You can also get priority vouchers, which can be used to get 50% off your Aeroplan redemption. So for example, if something costs 25,000 points, instead you only have to pay 12,500 points. The method to earn the vouchers is as follows. If you spend 4,000 status qualifying dollar, you get one voucher. If you spend 7,000 status qualifying dollar, you get two voucher. If you spend 10,000 status qualifying dollar, you get three voucher. If you spend 15,000 status qualifying dollars, you get four voucher. And then moving on forward, you get one voucher for every 5,000 status qualifying dollars spent. And the increment would be 20,000, 25,000, all the way to 50,000 status qualifying dollar for a total of 11 vouchers earned. If you have 25K or 35K Aeroplan status, you can only redeem your voucher for flights within Canada in the US in economy. If you have 50K Aeroplan status, you can redeem your voucher for up to premium economy in North America. If you have 75K Aeroplan status, you can redeem your voucher for up to premium economy worldwide. If you have Super Elite status, you can redeem your voucher for up to business class worldwide. If you have Aeroplan 50K, 75K, and Super Elite, you can also get a status pass which can bestow your elite privileges to others even if you're traveling separately. Status pass recipients will also enjoy Air Canada priority services on their journey, including priority check-in, security, boarding, and Maple Leaf Lounge access. The last thing we're gonna cover in this video is the latest perk that the new Aeroplan program is giving to their members, which is the family sharing program. Within the family sharing program, you can share with up to 8 Aeroplan members within your family, and the lead family can invite up to 7 members. The lead family member can designate a family member on who can contribute or redeem points. Aeroplan will not ask for proof of familial relations. This is an honor system. You must remain in the family for 3 months, and you cannot join another family group for 6 months if you do leave one. Sharing works on both earning and redeeming, and points will be deducted from everyone, and the ratio is based on who has the most points. So here's an example of the points deduction ratio. For example, your family has 3 members. There's Bill, Sally, and Jeremy. Bill has 300,000 points, Sally has 200,000 points, and Jeremy has 100,000 points. In total, there's 600,000 Aeroplan points between each of the family members. Because Bill has 300,000 points, that's 50% of the total pool of points. Sally's 200,000 points is 33.3% of the total amount of points within the pool. And Jeremy's 100,000 points is 16.6% of the total points. That means if Bill redeems 100,000 Aeroplan points for a flight, then the following points reduction will happen. Because Bill has 50% of the total amount of points, then 50,000 points will be taken from his account. Because Sally has 33.3% of the total points, then 33,000 points will be taken from Sally's account. And because Jeremy has 16.6% of the total points, then roughly 17,000 points will be taken from his account. So as you can see, the family sharing perk is actually quite good. And if you do have a family and you have somebody that earns most of the amount of points, for example, someone in your family has a business and they run all their business expenses onto their credit card and they end up with millions amount of points, then they can share it within their family and it's an easier way for everyone to redeem their points. Now obviously the new Aeroplan program has its bad side as well, because now it's going to cost you more points to redeem on flights to the Atlantic zone, to many places in the Pacific zone, as well as in South America. The biggest perk in my opinion in the new Aeroplan program is the ease of use, as well as the lower amount of points that you need for short haul flights, as well as some other sweet spots such as Vancouver to Tokyo. If you enjoyed this video and you found it helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave your comments below. And don't forget to sign up to our Travel and Live Free newsletter, where you can get a 10-step cheat sheet on how to travel around the world. You'll also get the latest tips and strategies on how to save money on travel for Canadians, how to go on around the world adventure travel for Canadians, and how to use travel to get more freedom in your life as a Canadian. You can sign up for the newsletter in the description below. Until next time, I'll see you then.